Good evening, Biff and TV. Tonight we've got another video for you. This is following on from the J-Paul review keg on the Phillips Perfect Draft. What I've done is I've also got a can of it as well, and I thought maybe what we could do is a quick review of the difference between what you get in the can and what you get out of the machine. Someone that's looking at maybe buying themselves a keg of it might want to try before they buy. I'll give you a good idea of whether it's a good comparison or not. And anyone that's thinking about a perfect draft that normally drinks this stuff in a can and is thinking about buying a perfect draft, but is thinking, actually, can I just enjoy the same beer out of, you know, a can or whatever it is, you know? I think I'm always keen to know as well, is there a major taste difference between the two? So, yeah, we've done the video previously about J-Paul and what we thought of it, so you can watch that video. This can I got in a Father's Day bundle with about three or four other cans, and it came from Beerhawk. But you can buy these, they're about nearly £1.50 a can or something like that. You get them in most supermarkets. I know Tesco's definitely sell them, so if you want to get yourself down there to try before you buy, always a very good shout. But spoiler, obviously I've had the beer on the Perfect Draft and I thought it was generally really nice. So what I'm also going to do as well, I'm going to put the beers in identical glasses, so there's no way that it's going to impact the taste of the beer or the experience, so it's a pretty much a fair test. I'm going to quickly top up my one in here and then we'll pour it into here, we'll compare them, see what we think and take it from there. Yeah, it's a lively little number, but look at adverts and stuff, that's how it's supposed to pour. So we'll open up the can, we'll pour the can, have a look at the two. I mean, J-Paul, been around since about 2005. It's the flagship beer for Thornbridge, and it's one of the first sort of craft beers really to hit the scene in 2005 and help lift them really. Now it's, you know, it's a very, I don't think most people have heard of it. It's 5.9% in alcohol volume, so it's not a, you know, like most of these IPAs, probably not necessarily a session beer, but Perfect Draft, and this is the one from the can. When you look at these two, you can tell straight away the one from the can has a lot more carbonation. And if you can see that, more carbonation than the one you get out of the Perfect Draft. Perfect Draft is keg beer. This is the stuff that's the cans and bottles. They brew it slightly different, and the reason being is they need it to last longer. The thing is, it could be sat with direct sunlight on it. It could be sat in quite a warm environment, like a supermarket, for a while, where these are a little bit different. These are in a sort of a bag inside a keg. So smell-wise, Perfect Draft. It smells lovely. You smell that fruity aroma. Smells nice, you know, nice, it's an IPA. The stuff on the can, that's a little bit more, that's a stronger smell. That's definitely stronger, and it's not the same. If you were, you wouldn't think it's the same. The smell is definitely different. Looks wise, now I always think with these, it's kind of the lacing on the glass, and I always think, you know, that's always a good indication of what you're getting with these. Very similarly, I think there's a little bit more lace on the glass of the Phillips Perfect Draft, but that's not shocking, we've seen that before. Taste wise, let's go with the Perfect Draft first. Nice, smooth, no bitter aftertaste. It's a really nice IPA. Anyone that's got a Perfect Draft and considering it, you must step out of your comfort zone and try all the different beers. Don't just stick to lagers or IPAs or Abbey beers or whatever it is. Try them all, because on this machine, they kind of put them on steroids, and you know, I've not come across one I haven't enjoyed. Nice, enjoyable beer. Let's go to the can. That smell, not a nice smell. Okay, way more carbonated. It's almost as if, like, when you drink it, you're taking a load of bubbles with it at the same time. And it's a lot more bitter. It tastes similar, but it's just a bit smoother. Sorry, it's a bit thinner. It's not got as much body to it as the stuff from the Perfect Draft. and it's just, it's got a harsher mouthfeel to it. It's just more carbonated. You notice that carbonation. Just not as enjoyable. It's that bitterness as well at the back end. Not the nicest. This is smoother. It's almost a different beer, to be honest. Smoother, way more enjoyable. It's that back end. You know, you're almost waiting for it to, but it doesn't kick you. Doesn't have that real bitter, like, ugh, back into it. Doesn't. Just smooth, easy drinking. So comparing the two, it definitely tastes nice from the Phillips Perfect Draft than it does out of the can. You could go as far as trying the can, see if it's something you're going to enjoy. I think if you like it out of the can, then you're definitely going to like it out of the Phillips Perfect Draft. Biggest difference is being the lacing on the glass is the big one. You get way better lacing on these Phillips Perfect Drafts. And it's just got better body to it. It's a bit heavier, so it carries the cold. So I think it's a little bit more enjoyable. And it's just a nicer, more enjoyable beer. You don't get that carbonation mouthfeel. So I'm going to sign off and say, great beer. Perfect Draft wins it again. I'll see you on the next one.